Okay.
The ground level of a rainforest is known as the forest floor. Here, among the shadows of the immense vegetation and towering foliage, species both large and small make good use of the thick underbrush. When threatened, the small yellow-backed duiker dives into hiding places provided by the forest, moving easily with its arched back and specially shaped legs. And even though the bongo possesses impressive horns, this large antelope also uses cover as its best protection. The forest floor provides an abundance of food as well as safety. Domestic feeders such as duikers and bongos find leaves, buds, seeds, bark, and fruit, while the small herds of dwarf forest buffalo graze along forest clearings, often bringing them to farmland at the edge of the human world. The second layer of a rainforest is called the understory. It is comprised of small trees and plants that survive on the limited amount of sunlight that gets through the layers above. Lurking in the low branches are found two of the forest's most successful predators, the genet and the leopard. Both are agile hunters who hide in the understory's broad leaves, waiting to attack by ambush. Patterned coats providing natural camouflage combined with hunting at night to make both predators nearly invisible to their prey. Some leopards are born with darker fur, giving them the incorrect title of black panthers. While the black color aids in nighttime hunting, it is a disadvantage in daytime, less effectively breaking up the animal's outline. The encroachment of humans on the rainforest has meant two very different fates for these sleek and beautiful animals. The genet thrives near humans, even being made into a pet. Unfortunately,
understory.
The leopard's survival is less certain due to increased hunting both for its magnificent coat and the threat it poses to livestock.
Many rainforest animals are nocturnal, meaning they are active at night. Most have special adaptations for
just like the other ones,
the dark,
like nurse sharks, zebra sharks, white-spotted bamboo sharks, gray.
Night is also a good time for finding food, and there is less competition.
Gray bamboo sharks, pork jackson sharks, horn sharks,
aggressive sharks,
angel sharks, wobbegongs,
aardvarks,
armadillos, bats, owls, and wild cats. Yep.
Each plant and animal in the rainforest plays an important role in the ongoing cycle of life. Plants act as producers, using sunlight, water, and carbon dioxide to create food and oxygen for animals. The larger animal species are consumers, eating plants or other animals. And most small species, notably the insects, play the role of decomposers, helping to break down dead and decaying matter, recycling it into soil nutrients that will be used by producers. Many species also cooperate for survival in a special relationship called symbiosis. The honey badger teams with a loud bird known as the honey guy. When the guy finds a beehive, it lets out a noisy call that alerts the badger. The badger then rips open the hive, and both animals enjoy the sweet honey inside. The canopy is formed by the wide tops of the tallest and oldest trees, which catch most of the sunlight. The abundance of leaves, shelter, and fruit makes the canopy an ideal home for many animals, such as monkeys and birds, as well as their predators, such as snakes and cats. The colobus monkey moves with great ease among the highest treetops in the forest, making spectacular leaps between branches. The color of the coat camouflages this monkey effectively in the foliage, and it can stay silent for hours if need be in the event of danger. The cat-like palm civet mostly feeds on fruit near villages and is a notorious banana thief. The civets signal each other with loud cries which can fill the rainforest night. The rainforests of equatorial Africa belong to the tropical rainforest group. Tropical rainforests are found along the Earth's equator and are very humid, with rainfall averaging 80 inches per year. The forest is constantly recycling rainwater. Trees take water up through their roots and release it back into the air through the leaves at their tops. The water gathers in heavy clouds overhead, which send it back down as rain. Rainforests near Africa's coasts, such as Togo, Benin, and Nigeria, enjoy the most abundance of water, soaking in great quantities of rain through the monsoons, which blow in from the ocean. The emergent layer rises above the canopy and is made up of understory, canopy, and vines that break out of the canopy below. The hornbills and other birds are the main species that occupy this highest level, over 100 feet above the forest floor. The large horn on this bird's bill is known as a casque, and the hornbill can use its massive beak to kill snakes that venture into the emergent layer to hunt. Hornbills move easily through the treetops, hopping from branch to branch, and will dive down into the rainforest's canopy to feed on many fruits and berries.